Hey guys, my name is Scoby. Today I'm going to be showing you how to overclock your monitor in Windows. This is going to be a nice, quick and easy tutorial. Let's jump right into this. So the first thing you want to do is come to your desktop and we're going to be right clicking and looking for our Nvidia or AMD control panel. You also want to make sure you have your latest graphic drivers installed. But once this is done, simply open up your control panel and you'll be brought to this window. So the first thing you want to do when you get to this page is come to the change resolution option on the left hand side underneath display. And from here, we're going to be selecting the monitor we would like to use, or in this case, overclock. So the monitor I want to overclock in this case is my AOC monitor. And underneath here, you can see we have a couple different resolution options. Now, our goal here is to make another resolution option, a customized one, that's going to allow us to experiment with different hertz and different frame rates to see what actually works for our monitor without it giving issues, flickers, tearing, and whatnot. So how we're going to be doing this is by coming down to the bottom, and we're going to be clicking on the Customize tab down here. From here, what you want to do is check this box on the bottom to enable resolutions not exposed by this display, and then we're going to be creating a new custom resolution. So what you want to do is enter the height and width pixels of your actual monitor. So in my case, mine is a 2560 by 1440, and then your default refresh rate should stay in your monitor when you first open this up. So in my case, my default refresh rate for my monitor is 60, but in this case, we're going to be overclocking the monitor to see what we can get out of it without going too crazy on the monitor, so it doesn't get any weird effects, flickers, or like screen shaking. So what I'd recommend doing is whatever your base hertz rate is, increase it by 10. So in this case, that would be 70. I would leave the scan type on progressive. I would leave the standard on automatic. You don't really need to touch anything else. Leave everything else as default. All you want to do is increase your hertz by 10 and come down here to the bottom and click test. So if you put your hertz to 70, click test, and your screen doesn't freak out, doesn't go black, and doesn't start shaking and tearing, I'd recommend adding 5 to that. So in that case, if your screen goes fine at 70 hertz, put it to 75 and then test it again. So your goal with this step is to get as high as you can in the hertz rate without your monitor freaking out. So you want to continually increase your hertz, keep testing until your monitor starts freaking out, starts tearing, or whatever issues come up on your monitor. It really depends on the monitor and the luckiness of your panel, so it can vary from monitor to monitor. Even the exact same model of monitor might get a different one. Say if you and your friend both have a monitor, you might end up getting 75, whereas your friend might only get 66. It's just kind of a look at the draw. So in this case, if you get to 75 and you start to see blackness, you start to see screen tearing and stuff, I'd recommend taking it down by 1. And you want to keep repeating the process until you get to the highest refresh rate you can without any issues on your screen. So sadly for me, I could only manage about 63 hertz on my actual panel. I was hoping to get around 70, but you can't always win them all. But in this case, it really depends on your panel and it's a little bit of luck. So all you need to do is keep trying and testing until you get to your actual desired result. In this case, I'm going to be closing mine down as I already have mine made. But once you have a custom resolution made, it should show up in this box. What I want to do is check to enable this and then click OK. From here, we're going to be coming down to our resolution tab down here, and we're going to be scrolling up to the very top and looking for our custom tab. What you want to do is check this custom tab, and then you'll notice your refresh on the right hand side will update. As you can see, it shows 63 hertz. From here, all you want to do is come down to the bottom right, click apply, and then your monitor will refresh and it will update to your actual desired frame rate. It'll say your desktop has been configured. Would you like to keep these changes? You'll click yes. And then your monitor will be refreshed to that current refresh rate. So right now I'm running my monitor on 63 hertz because that's the most stable I could get out of it. Now I should mention increasing the refresh rate of your monitor can deteriorate the life of it. Not by much, but it can make it last a little bit less longer in the long run. But this, like I said, can depend on your monitor, but it really does not make that much issue long term. It's maybe takes a fraction of your life off your monitor, but it's just something to keep in mind, but it's really going to do not that much harm. But anyway guys, it's as easy as that to overclock your monitor. Let me know what refresh rate you got down in the comments down below. Let me know if you got more than 63 hertz. I read someone online that someone got 66 with this monitor, so it's pretty sad to see I got exactly 3 less than that, but whatever, you win some, you lose some. Anyway guys, if you enjoyed this tutorial, be sure to drop a like, subscribe if you're new, check out the other videos on the channel. If you want to donate to me and support the channel, I'm going to leave a link down in the description below to my PayPal. Of course, there's no pressure if you can't. Anyway guys, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, as always, keep it saucy. Peace.